everyone, it's Nonna Grace, and I'm from Western New York, and I want to say thank you to those of you that actually asked a question in the comments yesterday, and so they will be answered today. I may have put the answer in one or two, but I don't think I did. I think I saved it for now. The one question was from Katie, Lee's Arkansas bound. She wanted to know if I had ever canned any food or have butchered any of my animals. When I grew up, my parents did a lot of canning. I have canned. I used to can only hot peppers, though. And as far as butchering, my dad used to butcher the animals. We never saw the butchering. We never saw the killing part. We always saw the actual cleaning part and the preparing them for the freezer part. But I've never done my own. I've only eaten my eggs is all I've. And if there was any extra birds, my brother would take them and he would dispatch of them. And then he would get to have the meat from the bird. Kimber from Every Day with Kimber asked, well, she mentioned that I had a lot of jobs and different positions and which was the most satisfying. Well, I really felt that the working at the school was probably the most satisfying, but the one that I liked the most, that I had the most fun at, really was the McDonald's job when I was hostess. I found that that one was the most fun. Dave from Ghetto Van Adventures, he wants me to document Jim's day. And Jim chuckled.
That would be awful hard to do.
It would be. But it could be maybe a little bits and pieces of it I could copy. I could document, but not the whole day. Sylvia from Sylvia Hudell, she wanted to know if my dog has ever hurt any of the chickens. No, I don't leave Jake out there alone. I don't trust Jake. I think if Jake had the opportunity, he would chase. In fact, when the kids are here, I tell them don't run because Jake will chase. But whether he would actually catch them and do something with them, I don't think so. But you never know, so you just don't chance it. Mr. G from Mr.G 1965, he said I could talk about the meetup that is coming up. And it's with the motor vloggers. And it's going to be in Tazewell, Virginia on June 11 and 13 is what the dates are, but you can come in on the 10th, and there is supposed to be a ride in or a ride something. I don't know exactly. We're planning on going on the 10th, but I don't know if I'll be there in time for this riding thing or not. Diane Thoroughman, she wanted to know what my favorite crafts and hobbies were. I enjoy a lot of things. I enjoy paper craft. I enjoy crocheting. Knitting. Am I good at any of these? Probably not.
You're good at all
of them. No, I'm not. And then yes, I like to do beading. I like to make bracelets. I learned how to crochet bracelets. I think I did a video where I showed my bracelets. I didn't show you that I was doing it, but I did learn how. I enjoy learning new techniques. I did do crewel work, but crewel work is really the same as its name tells it all. I don't care for crewel work. I can embroider and I can cross stitch. I can do a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm. That's why I say you're good at all of them.
I have a lot of junk because of all these good things that I like to do. Wendy from Spitfire Red, she wanted to know if the hens picked that were being picked on, if they ever fought. Well, you know, they usually back down because they know that they're the bottom of the barrel. If they're getting bonked on the head or on the side or attacked in some way, they will back down. They usually don't fight. Their roosters, no, that's another story. The roosters would fight to the death is what they would do. They would fight until somebody gave up and decided that he was the top rooster. I did have some roosters do that a long time ago where they got out of their rooster house and I found them in the hen area. And they were getting along pretty good then because they'd already fought. I didn't see the fight, but I kept the one that was not as aggressive. And then I ended up not keeping that one anyways because it was wearing the feathers off the back of the girls, and I don't like that. Mr. Pretty Boy, even though he's not pretty, somebody mentioned that he has very long tail. Yes, he does. He has very long feathers in the back. But he's been a very gentle rooster. And I do have, and somebody asked me how many chickens I had a long time ago. This was asked. Well, I counted them today. We were able to count them. I have exactly 20 hens, and that's counting Mr. Brown and one rooster. So I have quite a few chickens. And I got 13 eggs today. And I think I got 13 yesterday or 14. I don't know. I've got a lot of eggs. Something. A lot of eggs I got. Okay, Jill from Fiber Foozie Craft asked if I was a hairdresser or a barber. And I was a hairdresser. I am a hairdresser. I have a license to do hair. Barbering is the only thing difference between a barber and the hairdresser in my state is that the barbers can shave. They can use a razor and shave you. They can do that, whereas we cannot do that. But in the mid-70s, they said that women could cut men's hair. So we've been cutting men's hair for a very long time. But I have a hairdressing license. I don't have a barber license. Marsha from Marsha's Mush and Stuff, she wanted to know when I got my chickens. When did I first get chickens? Well, the first two I got was April 6th. I could have swore they were hens, but they weren't. Guess what? They were roosters. Both of them were. And the sad part is I named them Gertrude and Stella. And I didn't keep them, no. They ended up going back to my brother. When I found out that they were roosters, I gave them back to him because that's where I got these two little birds. Then we went to the farm store. And then April 30th, I got my Buff Orpingtons, and I had gotten six of them. I had one die, and I gave one away. Mm-hmm. But I have five still. Why do I still have five?
I have four.
Or I have four? Oh, I guess I do have four. I have one that looks like a Buff, but it's not mm-hmm. It's a Buff
we
mix.
We have a couple that
are Buff mixes.
Are
but
buff
I have,
mix.
But I have four Buffs of the original, and that was April 30th. I didn't put the year down. Why didn't I do that?
I don't know.
Well, I've had them about 5 years. I'm pretty sure. About 5 years. And my Buffs are still laying eggs, which they usually don't, but mine are. Must be very happy little birds. They're still laying. And I gave Louise to my brother because the rooster didn't like her. And she's still laying eggs. And she's now the top hen. He's got just a couple hens, but now she's the top hen. And the last question was from Pam, from Simply Pam. How old was I when I got married? I was 28. Do you want to know how old Jim was? He was 22.
Yep.
And they used to tease me about robbing the cradle. Good grief. He had lived more than I'd lived, that's for sure. I was one of those young country girls that was very naive, extremely naive. And we didn't have a very long engagement, which was fine with my parents because my parents had a pretty short engagement. They had exactly 8 months from the moment they met to the time they got married, and that's exactly how long we did. I think it's sort of silly to have too long of an engagement because after a while, they just move in with each other, and then they have families, and they're still not married. It's like, why did they bother to do that when they could have gotten married and do it the order instead of the cart before the horse? They had the horse first.
No, instead of having the horse in front of the cart, they had the cart in front of the horse.
Right, something like that. You wanted the horse before the cart, not the cart before the horse. Yeah.
But I was not a city kid either. I did live in
you
the
lived
in
where
the
you
village,
could walk to town.
Right on the edge of the village, but it was not a huge.
But you had a lot more freedom than I did. I didn't have any freedom.
Well,
when you think about it.
Boys tended to have a lot more freedoms back then than what the girls did.
Probably. Well, that is the video for today. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will talk to you all again tomorrow. Bye-bye.